Okie doke. Let's go do crew update. We don't have anyone hanging in here. Rex and the Primarch. Or elsewhere. Alright, let's see what these two have to say.
You see the vids of the Maw taking down the Reaper? Man, I wish I could have been there.
It was an awesome sight.
I'm glad the diplomats were on. A Krogan and a Turian in the same room is a fight waiting to happen.
Commander, Admiral Hackett has requested your help with a Cerberus fighter base on Novaria.
Novaria? Interesting. Cerberus fighter base on Novaria. Land on Novaria to disable the base's defenses. Interesting. Okay. Just needed to take a quick break here.
The Turians have given us top-level access to their combat data. Their ships are already moving in to help the Alliance fleet. You actually secured a Krogan-Turian alliance. It's one thing to hear about Commander Shepard.
Oh.
It's another to see her in action.
The adoration. She's like, yep, yep, I'm awesome.
Commander?
Mal? Any mail? Oh, we got a bunch of stuff. ANN alert. New article on Reaper. From Alliance News Network Information Partners. ANIP. Pharos. A group of colonists on Pharos have mounted a defensive against arriving Reaper forces, holding them back long enough for civilians from nearby colonies to escape. The informal militia from Zeus Hope, said to be survivors of a savage Geth attack several years ago, has repelled initial Reaper landing attempts with a level of wartime competence more common to seasoned platoons. Cool. The colonies are using improvised weapons as well as supply savage from a defunct exogeny facility. Oh, that's her. I remember her. This colony is our home, colony spokesperson Lisbeth Bainham said. We've survived worse, and we know how to fight together. The colony is expected to have time for full evacuation before more Reaper forces arrive. Cool. That's pretty cool. We're still referencing the beginning of Mass Effect, the first Mass Effect. Still fighting from Shiala, dear Commander Shepard. I don't know if you've seen the articles, but the people of Zeus Hope are fighting again. This time it's the Reapers instead of the Geth. I'm not sure if you remember me, but you helped me back on Ilium. Oh, was she the Asari we came across? The Thorian is dead now, I can confirm that, but the spores in our bodies remain, and on some level we are still connected. I'm not sure. This is not necessarily a bad thing. As we fight back the Reapers, we feel each other and act with one mind, ignoring pain when the need arises. I'm sure I'm still indoctrinated. I remember Sovereign's voice in my mind when I went willingly to the Thorian as its thrall. But my connection to the people of Zeus Hope is stronger. It drowns out the Reaper voices. Is that possible? This situation is imperfect and dangerous. Perhaps the colonists should separate for their own safety. But with one mind, the untrained fight with the skill of veteran commandos. Our force is strong. I have not forgotten how you helped us, how you spared me. We are leaving Pharos soon, and when the time comes, we will fight with you. That'd be cool. Making babies? Impressive work. From General Corinthus, Commander Shepard. When you first arrived on Minae, I had a hard time seeing how you flying off with one of our best generals would benefit our fight against the Reapers. However, as I now watch Turian and Krogan fighters working together to take down a Reaper destroyer, I must admit I am impressed. You've brokered an alliance that many thought impossible. Palavin might be saved after all. With great respect, General Corinthus, Minae Command. Making babies? From Erdnod Rex, Shepard. Making babies again will be fun. Soon as this war is over, let's just say I'll do my part to build our numbers back up. Yeah, I'm sure you'll enjoy every second of it, Rex. You really came through for us. I'm proud to call you my friend. Eve is in the Kelphic Valley enlisting support from the other clans and spreading the word. She's going to be a great leader. Most of the males won't like me sharing power with her, but too bad. I run the show. We're off to save the Turians now, since apparently they forgot how to hold a gun. Your regrettable decision. From Dalatras Linran. Commander, I am deeply disappointed by your actions on Juchanka. As I thought I made clear, curing the genophage will have long-term consequences. I gotta look back at my video. I thought I was talking to the Dalatras in the, well, hologram form. So maybe I was talking to somebody else. Once the Reaper threat has passed, our combined forces will be so depleted that no race in the galaxy will be capable of stopping a resurgent Krogan. Moreover, the Krogan will undoubtedly seek revenge for the Genophage, and the Salarian Union will be among their first targets. When that day comes, Commander, the blood of my people will be on your hands. Thanks for that. I am also ashamed to learn that our own scientist sacrificed his life carrying out your orders. Yeah, I know you wouldn't be happy about that either. This is a dark day not only for my people, but all of galactic civilization. Dalatras Linran, Salarian Union. Yeah, well, screw you, buddy. Let's go check up on... Oh, we got a war asset for Zeus Hope Collins. Here's what I was wondering about that. I guess now we have him. Oh.
All right, my turn.
Did say he was here.
What's the first order an Alliance commander gives at the start of combat?
I give up.
Correct.
All right, big guy. What do you call it when a Turian gets killed by a horrible spiky monster?
Friendly fire. Come on, that one goes back to Shang-Chi.
How you gotta respect the classics?
How many humans does it take to activate a dormant mass relay?
Uh-oh.
602. 600 to vote on it, one to ask the Asari for technical help, and one to request a seat on the council afterward. How do you know when a Turian's out of ammo?
He switches to the stick up his ass as a backup weapon. Why does the Alliance hire pilots with brittle bone disease?
Oh.
You're shitting me. The Turian military has one about me?
Oh, absolutely. I heard it myself from a private back on Palavin.
All right, why does the Alliance hire pilots with brittle bone disease?
So their Marines can beat someone in hand-to-hand drills.
Damn, you need to tell James that one. Hey, what's the hardest part about treating a Turian who took a rocket to one side of his face?
Figuring out which side took the rocket.
Is that it? Now, I looked at the map. It does say Garrus is there. What's up?
Never thought I'd see the Krogan and the Turians team up.
Oh, I'll talk
Even
to him.
The Reapers have to be a little nervous about pissing them off.
I'd say more than a little.
I'm sorry about Morden.
He was a friend.
He was a good man.
Yeah, he was always running those tests. And one time he tagged me in the middle of the night to ask how many livers humans had. And this bump on my elbow? He said it was just a mild bone deformation, but I'm pretty sure he stuck a probe in there.
Glad it was just your elbow.
I always thought he was crazy. Useful, but crazy. Then he gives up his own life.
To save the Krogan. Doesn't do much to disprove the crazy theory, huh?
I guess not. But he was one of ours.
So now that we got the Krogan and the Turians, what now?
He is useful.
The Krogan help us turn the tide on Palavin. They can shoot at something useful for a change.
Dig till we hit daylight, huh? Works for me.
So how does it feel knowing Krogan will be singing songs about you until the end of time? I think it would be an honor.
I'd like for them to sing songs about Morden, but I don't think that'll happen. I did it for the war, to help everybody.
To be honest, I did it so the Krogan would help your people.
And believe me, it won't be forgotten. Our fleets will be there for Earth. I'll make sure of it.
I know you will.
And let's hope Rex keeps running the show on T'Chanka. Maybe we should hire a food taster for him. Imagine the carnage if some young, hot-headed Krogan took over.
Yeah, really.
It could happen.
I know. It's a chance we have to take. But I have to say, if it wasn't my own world that needed the help, I might have taken that Salarian deal.
I have to be honest. I was a little tempted. I thought we wouldn't have their help if I didn't, agree to this demand.
I'd be lying if I said I didn't consider it.
Exactly.
Anyone would have second thoughts about the Krogan. They just better remember you didn't act on it and return the favor.
Mm-hmm. Plus two reputation. What I really want them to know is that a Salarian sacrificed himself so that the genophage will be cured. Oh, Edie's not even here.
I wonder where all the Krogan will live now. I've never seen what you'd call a house on T'Chanka. I wonder where all the Krogan will live now.
Commander.
Alright. Alright, let's go check up on everybody else. Oh, do I want to go check on my, let's go check on this war asset. Private Westmoreland. It's just right back here. Alliance. Zeus Hope Colonists. Yeah, it was the Asari. Shiala was rescued by Commander Shepard from the Thorian on Zeus Hope, and now she leads a militia of Zeus Hope colonists waging a surprisingly effective campaign against encroaching Reapers. Shiala suspects the group's prior connection to the Thorian gives their soldiers an uncanny ability to sense one another, allowing them to think and act as one in battle. The long-term consequences of this connection are unknown, but for now at least, its efforts are helping the cause. Nice. Excuse me, I'm trying to get the hell out of here. Okay, so we'll check up everyone else. Check up on everyone else. I'm guessing that,
Commander Shepard.
Yes, I am. I'm guessing that the doctor is back in the med bay. Let me check the cabin really quick. Feed fish. I'll pick up this mask. Death mask. Plus 10 melee damage. Developed by Tyrell Advanced Communications Corporation, TAC. The latest version of the Death Mask's Death Mask offers exceptional protection and real-time data feedback that helps coordinate the wearer's melee attacks. And it looked like some kind of bug. Okay. Shuttle bay. They're here. But where? Oh, he's over here.
You could have seen that gun on T'Chanka firsthand. I cut the auditory emulators and watched that Cerberus cruiser gracefully and silently disintegrate. Beautiful.
Sometimes I worry about you, man.
Just one more diagnostic suite. Everything is in order.
Okay. James?
You think that cure they dispersed could do anything to us? We're not going to start growing scales or anything, right?
No.
Maybe now that we have the Krogan on board, we can go back to fighting the Reapers.
Yep.
I was looking at the specs on that Reaper you took out on T'Chanka. That was one of the small ones? Don't get me wrong, it's still dead, but damn. There was nothing small about it.
Okay, I wonder how much smaller, because it was really small compared to the Thresher Maw Queen. and basically wrapped it up and crushed it into pieces, into nothingness.
Hey.
Hey. Okay, when he goes, hey, that means we leave. Do I want to mess with anything? Nah, not really. We're good. I don't know what the point of that dog is. Engineering. Alright, let's just go check in on Javik and Allers. Go on. Criticize the Krogan or Salarians or the Turian.
Commander?
You settling in, Javik?
I believe some of the crew wishes to be my friend. That is not my purpose here. Also, I find I need to wash my hands. The residue of the ship is strong.
Hmm.
How so?
I have been exploring. There are traces of those who lived on the Normandy before. I detected a human female. Her genetic structure was unnatural, as if artificially created.
Oh, yeah.
Sounds like Miranda.
Miranda, yeah.
And a Drell. There was illness in him.
Thane.
Yep, Thane.
And a Krogan who lived in these quarters. He was undergoing a metamorphosis.
Grunt.
His memories were confused, not organic to his mind. There was great confusion and turmoil.
I still can't wrap my head around that. Reading information like you do.
For my people, it was as natural as breathing.
Evolution's an amazing force.
Our scientists believed it was the only force in the galaxy that mattered. They called it the cosmic imperative. The strong flourished, the weak perished. The governments of your cycle seem concerned with ensuring the survival of all.
Hmm. Cosmic imperative, huh?
Was this imperative just your scientists' opinion, or did they prove something we don't know?
The universe had already proven it. They only had to look around.
And saw what, exactly?
Extinction is the rule of law in the cosmos. The natural order of things. The weakest species are doomed.
The weak need protection. And I know what you're gonna say. Once I say the weak need protection, only divides us and makes us weaker as a result.
It's the duty of the strong to protect the weak. Otherwise we'd have anarchy.
But those who had nothing to offer would be eliminated.
So conflict should be a way of life.
Evolution demands it. The strong grow stronger by dominating the weak. It is for the greater good of all. Though I do not think your Asari approves of my beliefs.
Nope.
Liara? I think she just had a different idea about what Protheans were like.
I think she was disappointed.
We are all a product of our time. Had I been born in this cycle, perhaps I would be the noble scholar she wishes me to be.
Hmm. You? Really?
You think you'd like that? It's a whole different line of work.
I wouldn't know. Living a life of constant war. Taking life in every battle.
I see how it could be tough to see outside the box.
Hmm.
It is the only box I have known.
Hmm.
It shapes me, as stone is shaped by the one who carves it. The stone has no choice in the form it will take. You and I, Commander, war is our sculptor, and we are prisoners to its design.
Maybe not much longer. We win this and we'll both be set free.
The only difference is, what would he do with himself? He has no race, nowhere to call home. Is it even worth it for him to exist, you know? What would he do with himself?
Thank you, Commander. I have seen the death of a Reaper. It has been a long time.
It's pretty awesome.
Let's hope it's the first of many.
Yes, a difficult fight remains. I would have accepted the Salarian deal and not told the Krogan. Morality and friendship do not matter now. Your allies are simply resources to use against the Reapers.
Mm-hmm. I know you would have chosen that. Well, I'm just glad I'm in charge then.
If the Krogan seek retribution for the past, Do not waste time on sterility plagues. Destroy them where they stand. In the meantime, they are useful cannon fodder against the Reapers. Do not care what others think. Do what you must.
Oh yeah? Does that include what you think?
Do not care what others think. Do what you must.
Alright, see you later, Javik. Can't pull your string and get any more responses, so I'll be on our way. Check in with Aller, see if she's making a report about the Krogan defeat.
Jennifer, yeah. Here, huh?
Awesome.
This beats the hell out of reporting on the Milgram City Council.
I don't think I've heard of Milgram. Which planet is that again?
Beckenstein. It's right next door to the Citadel. I'm a colony kid. Commander, got a minute?
What do you want to know?
Oh, we're being recorded.
You've just implemented a cure for the genophage. Millions of Krogan will start fighting the Reapers.
Correct.
What do you say to people who think humanity is starting another Rachni War and Krogan rebellions?
This is Krogan redemption.
It's easy to remember the worst of Krogan history, but you also need to remember the best.
Meaning?
The Krogan were heroes once, and they want to be heroes again. We're giving them that chance.
Are you aware that Clan Erdnot is already petitioning the Council for an embassy and rights to a colony world?
That can be negotiated.
The Krogan are coming to the aid of a Council homeworld. That's more than a lot of species can say. I helped them get the genophage cure. Anything more is between the Council and the Krogan.
There it is, straight from Commander Shepard. Until tomorrow, this is Diana Allers. Good night and stay strong. Okay, I'll cut that together with the rest of the segment and send it to Command for approval.
You don't be cutting me up and making my quotes out of context.
Commander.
I hate when people do that. Reporters. Let's check in on engineers. We got a war asset update again.
Commander.
Nothing to say, huh?
Commander.
All propulsion systems are running optimal. All propulsion systems are running optimal.
Well, these guys don't have anything to say. Interesting. Crew deck. Yep, Dr. Chakwas is back in medical. Oh, Edie's hanging out in the AI core. AI core is... by medical. Right. Anyone in here? I miss the idle chit-chat that used to happen over at this table. Oh well. Yeah, let's check in on them. Garrus isn't here. He's up with Joker. Those jokes were really funny, actually. You're back!
Nothing to report.
Nothing to say, huh? What powers here? Oh, really? Dominate. Pretty good for crowd control. I don't remember using anything like this. Well, in this series anyway. Let's take that. C- course that means... Oh, I get the points back. Good. Targets grow resistant to the power over time. Well, I'm probably only going to use it one power at a time. One target. Recharge speed. Duration. So at recharge speed and duration, well, under the effect, the target does 40% more weapon damage. Inflict massive nerve damage to the target, doing 50 points of damage per second. So it's dominated and takes damage. Target takes 30% more damage from all sources. The target does 60% more weapon damage and takes 50% less damage. This is all pretty interesting. Duration. That'll be helpful. Does 40%. So it's interesting. If I'm reading this right, you can either have damage done to it or have it do damage. Let's do that. Make it more effective rather than torture the poor thing. Which, it would make sense that if you're doing damage to it, it could break the domination. What you doing here, Edie?
What are you up to now?
I'm uploading data on the destroyed Reaper to the Turians. They are investigating possible Reaper structural weakness. Our data says Reaper capital ships such as Sovereign are of unique design. However, smaller Reaper destroyers bear similarities.
That one was small?
Relatively, yes. Ground attack ships are only 160 meters in height. Sovereign was approximately 2 kilometers.
Well, keep talking to the Turians. If there's a chink in the Reaper's armor, we all need to know it.
Just wondering why you're hanging out here to do that.
Hello, Shepard.
Everyone decided to move around. Well, at least Liara's in her normal spot.
Any sign of life?
The Reaper destroyed by the Thresher Maw appears to be completely inert, Doctor. We would need to send in teams to be sure.
Out of the question. Tell the Krogan to stay away. The genophage cured. The Krogan have no reason to hold back now, do they?
Nope.
Rex knows what he's doing, but can he keep the Krogan in check? Or will this be the start of another Krogan Empire?
One threat at a time, or one possible threat at a time.
Eve's organizing the female Krogan. She reminds me of some of the more formidable matriarchs I've known.
Like your own mother.
The Krogan won't let themselves fall by the wayside again. Not like they did after the rebellions. We'll have to get used to them having a bigger part in the galaxy.
Yep.
I hope the Krogan live up to their ancient legacy, and for the better. Hello, Shepard.
After all that, hello, Shepard. Mass relay traffic reports. Increase and decrease in recent relay traffic. Widow, 95% increase, which means everyone's flying to the Citadel. Omega 2, 65% increase. Tassal, 32% increase. Sorry, guys, I don't remember what all this other stuff is. Sinehand is 43% decrease. Pelion is 12% decrease. Charon and Shang-Chi Theta is unavailable, or are unavailable. Interesting. Upgrades. Okay.
A pleasure to see you.
Why, thank you. So, we go to the Citadel. And we have A small N7 mission. Cerberus fighter base. Interesting. We're fighting them so much more than in the first game. And in the second game, we were part of Cerberus. On Novaria. Oh, we've been there. We've actually been by there. So I might take care of that next episode then. Probably be a one or two part episode, and then we'll head to the Citadel. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time, and endure. In enduring, grow strong.